Hello girlies, welcome back to my channel. If I could turn back in time, these are the outfits that I would wear in college. So honestly, college has been a really different journey for me than most of y'all, because I was a very stubborn introvert when it came to college. I didn't talk to a lot of people, I didn't make a lot of friends. But then again, I had my share of fun. I participated in competitions and in college fests, and I had many other random memories that I'm going to cherish for the rest of my life. So yeah, in today's video, I'm going to share outfit ideas for different college occasions, because I really don't think I did a really good job during my college days. So yeah, I'm going to show outfit ideas for like making a good first impression in college, or random running late to college outfit idea, and even date after college outfit ideas. Also, those presentation looks, because I always feel it's better to look good in presentations than shittier presentations anyway, because honestly, I was so bad at my college presentations. I used to get so awkward and embarrassed when I was asked to talk in so many, asked to talk in front of so many people. I used to get super awkward. So I am so glad that time has passed. Anyway, we can start with outfit number one now. Starting off with one of my favorite looks, basic signature black tee with mom jeans. Tuck the top in, add a belt, and whoa, you're ready. This looks so good. And the final touch is obviously these boots. The top and denim both are from Zara. These boots are from Shein, and to be honest, not the comfiest, because I got a size bigger and never bothered to return it. This is the second outfit. This is legit what I used to wear during my college days. I didn't add a lot of things over here because I wanted to keep it very basic. This crop pullover is such a statement for like lazy girls outfit inspo, I feel. I just replaced the boots to the white shoes, and yeah, this also matches the white on the top, which is why I added white shoes. This high-rise skinny denim is again from Zara and also the most used denim in my wardrobe. To create one more look with this used to death denim, I replaced the pullover to this white top and cuffed the denim. I always believe that cuffing the denim really makes you look slightly taller. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Lastly, I DIY'd this denim jacket. I did a little raw hem and added this badge that I got from Shein. And yeah, I just feel like I value this jacket so much more now, obviously, because there was so much hard work behind it. Anyway, in case your college doesn't have a strict dress code, you can go for these baggy ripped denim along with a bodysuit. This one that I am wearing is from Kooz, and I think I got it for around 300 or 350 rupees. And in case you're that bit conscious like I was about traveling in public transport wearing sleeveless, you can always layer it up, my girls. This jacket is like of a polyester material and has a nice U cut, which is why I think it looks different than the other jackets that I own. For the next look, I'm gonna replace my boots to these pretty heels and the bodysuit to this crop top that I got from Shein. And this is one of my sale purchases that I'm so proud of. I love how it fits on my body. And in case you haven't noticed, I am wearing these shoes that I got recently. They're from Charles & Keith and has a very tiny heel to it, which is why it is super comfy even when you're traveling. To match the shoes, I added a black belt and a black backpack that I got from Lavi. Well folks, this is it for this look, but in case your college has a strict dress code, which I'm not aware of because it has been I think more than 5 years since I visited college, you can layer this crop top up with overalls. This one is from Forever 21. You can add any nice sneakers to it and you're good to go. I love this one because these shoes are from Lulu and Sky, and for short gals like me, it is perfect because it has a little bit of heel just to up my confidence. Although I wish that Drishti I was in college had more confidence irrespective of what she was wearing. But anyway, the past is the past. Done drifting. This is the final look. I would definitely suggest this look for a date after college hours, obviously. It shows a little bit of belly, just enough to make it the perfect combination of cute and hot. Thank you, ex-boyfriend, for the last line. And here's another IGTV inspired transition. In fact, this look itself is created from one of my Instagram videos, Grey Overdose series, in case you know what I mean. Anyway, adding this comfy as hell block heels that I got from H&M, along with this high-waisted trouser. It has a plaid print on it, which I really like. I'm gonna cut the sleeves now because I think it looks more like a boss lady and less slouchy after doing that. And if you want, you can leave it at that, but if you want to up your boss lady game, you can layer it up with this oversized blazer. This one's a size L and it's not slim fit because I don't like slim fit blazers. This one's a regular fit. I like this one because of the color and it's just oversized. I got it from Sarojini and it is one of my favorite purchases from there. To convert this presentation look to a more casual look, I'll replace the top with the cutest top in my closet. I love the little frill on the top and the fact that it is in a nice pastel shade is so cute. It has a little tie-up thing which makes the kid inside me so happy. To make it look more casual, we are gonna add these comfy sandals from H&M again. And that's pretty much it about this look. Another variation could be with these comfy high-rise palazzos. It has a little belt sort of detailing which in my opinion is quite a statement on its own. I'm gonna fold the top a little to show a little bit of my tummy because otherwise I thought it was looking quite camouflaging with the entire look. Adding this chola bag to complete my typical college inspired look from during my college days, but don't even ask me when that was. For the next look, I'm gonna switch my sandals, add a nice turtleneck because honestly it is getting a little cold and windy in many parts of India, especially where I live in. This look is so 90s inspired in all its ways already that I decided to add these sunglasses. I love that these have like a chain accessory to it that have been really in trend everywhere. This really also reminds me of my grandmother. She's the best. Also, this is the kind of fashion that I've been really loving the past couple months. The retro outfit inspiration. Another one for your project presentation days. This top is actually a bodysuit from Shein. The sleeves and the neckline of this dress again is very classy and formal. If my hair was like a little bit longer, I would have tied a neat ponytail with this look. The trousers are from Zara again. And to amp up this look, I added a belt that I got along with some other formal shorts. These heels may not be the comfiest option for many, especially if you travel a lot to your college. But as Huda Beauty says in her videos, you gotta do what you gotta do, girls. I'm wearing the same trouser and replacing the heels to boots and the top to this mustard top. I love that this is like a tiger color combination of mustard, yellow and black. This top is a local buy from Bandra and I'm not sure where exactly, but I'm guessing Hill Road. I love this 90s inspired collar detailing. It makes the entire look so chic. Dare I say, this is one of my favorite looks out of all the looks that I've created today. It's comfy and classy and something I wish I had worn during my college days for sure. I'm super spectacle about this look as I have no idea if colleges allow dresses. I hope they do. You can wear a solid color dress or like any t-shirt dress and add a nice pair of sneakers, preferably white. And yeah, you're good to go. As for me, I like to add a little bit of color to my looks. So maybe adding a pink denim jacket or maybe something like this, mixing like a camo jacket with this. I think I'm gonna settle for the camo jacket. It looks quite trendy and this jacket is again one of my favorites. So yeah. I'm a little over the typical kurti and churidar look. I like more of such looks like with short kurti and linen pants and yeah, these look so good and comfy. The kurti has a really lovely embroidery detailing. I think I got it from a shop in Santa Cruz and they had many Lucknowi kurtis as well. Adding my same old sandals for this look, this outfit in whole is so breathable and mild in terms of the color palette. The calmness of this look really speaks to me. I feel like my outfit series are never complete without at least one ethnic sort of look, and this one right here is my favorite. Coming to the last look and overall, this is also the look that I think rickshaw drivers or mechanics wear, as my friends call it, but irrespective, I love this look so much. If you're going to experiment, this outfit inspo is definitely for you. I'm adding the same old boots and black bag to complete this look. The outfit that I'm wearing is from H&M, and they have a few other variations in this as well. So yeah, that is it for my take on some college outfit inspirations that would help you to style your college outfits, hopefully. And I'll see you guys in my next video, hoping that this was helpful. Bye bye.